Carol in Athens, Georgia is up next. Hi there, Carol.
Hey, Kim. I am so excited to talk to you. I can't believe it.
Oh, you're here. Thank you.
I have listened to you forever, and I never thought I would get to talk to you, so I am so excited. And I have to tell you something real quick.
Yes.
Until I did my inquiry, I never knew what you look like. You know, I had a picture of you in my mind's eye. You are so pretty. You are not a nerd at all.
So, thank you. You're so complimentary. Thank you for that. What did you think I look like? You think it was like, you know, tall, dark hair?
A nerd, just, you know, brown, a bob, brown hair, bangs, you know, a nerd. Yeah.
Well, thank you for finally visiting our website.
You're so pretty.
Well, thank you. So, what's going on, Carol?
Okay, I'm going to try and make this quick. I have 27 years experience as a mainframe programmer. I programmed in COBOL and assembler language.
Wow. You know what? You were on the forefront.
Thank you. That's what I'm hoping. But I have been out of the field for a while. And you know that even if you're out of the field for an hour, you become a dinosaur. Your skills are obsolete.
Yeah, it happens.
So I do not know the new languages like Java and object-oriented.
Or Ruby or whatever it is. Okay, but you know COBOL. And let me tell you,
I do.
COBOL is a great skill to have right now at this moment.
That's what I was going to ask you.
Yeah, believe it or not, common business-oriented language. I remember learning COBOL in college with the pick statements.
I'm a nerd. I miss it. I want to get back into programming so bad.
Well, and you can. Because there has been a call out for people who are COBOL programmers to come out and help. Because, see, a lot of the state's unemployment systems, which, you know, are going crazy right now with the pandemic, were actually written in COBOL, and they're trying to find people that can actually go to work.
What I was going to ask you, I had heard that because of the coronavirus, a lot of companies, maybe not a lot, but some, were having to go back to update their old mainframe systems. And I wanted to know if that was true, and I wanted to know if that was true, if you knew how I could get my foot in the door, even though I don't know, you know, the Java and the
object-oriented. We had a guy on the show not too long ago. His name was Bill Henshaw. And he has an outfit out of Plainview, Texas. Pardon me.
And I'm writing it down.
And he's 78 years old, and he has.
I'm not that old.
Well, I think it's great though that, and he's rounded up about 350 IT professionals who are COBOL programmers. And he gives them jobs. And the name of his outfit is the COBOL Cowboys.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. So, hey, I could go anywhere because my son's grown and my husband's in heaven and, you know, I can go wherever.
Well, now you're up for an adventure. Now, you know, so give Bill a call and or send him an email. Tell him that you and I spoke, by the way. Again, because he'll remember being on the show. And then, but you can also check, you know, locally what's happening with maybe on dice.com. I don't know if you never looked there.
I do, but the thing is, I'm sorry, I am interrupting you.
The thing is,
they want COBOL, but they want everything else.
Okay.
You know,
well, then
that I don't know.
Okay, then Carol.
That's what they say they want.
You know what? So if you've gone to Dice and LinkedIn and Indeed and, you know, all the others, and then you know what? Try the COBOL Cowboys with Bill. And I'm going to put you on hold because Mandy may even still have his web address and some contact information for Bill. And it's an interesting time, isn't it? I mean, never would you have thought that a language that you used in the 60s and 70s and maybe into the 80s would suddenly come back and be in demand simply because the young people don't know how to fix it. So they're relying on people who have done this their entire lives to come in and kind of save the day. And Bill was quite the character. I remember talking to him. It was really amazing. Carol, do me a favor, since now you've talked to me and you've talked to everybody here on the show, I want you to make sure that you keep us posted about how you became a COBOL cowgirl.
Hey, thanks for watching. Now, a few things. Don't forget to click the like button and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. And for more digital know-how, check out all these other great links.